You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Dwight Madsen is our guest, former NSA official. Great mind on every angle here to give us his commentary and analysis. We're going to go to Eddie, Lona, Daniel, Sean, Charlie, folks that have been holding patiently. We're going to start going to you right now. Then we're going to get into a new report on the fact that now it's incubating up to 41 days in the body, 70 in the testicles. I mean, this is bad because then they can just spread, and you don't know they got it, folks. This is a nightmare scenario, how long this stuff lives. Eddie in New York, you had a point earlier, but we went to break. So restate what you were saying and get Wayne Madsen's take on it.
Yes, sir. No, I was just saying is that they have set up so many nails in place to drop the hammer that they have all these fail states set up, such as Russia, crisis in Ukraine, ISIS, Ebola, and to actually know where they're going to drop the hammer is kind of hard to say. But they have all these nails set up in place, so this way, if one fails, they can drop it on this one, or they can drop it on that one. And it's a lot harder for them since 9/11. Excuse me.
No, I agree with you. I mean, it's a lot harder for them to stage something where they can really get caught, where they run the whole thing themselves. It's easier to just use a crisis that's either already there or that's easier for them to hide that they're behind to then pose as the saviors. Wayne Madsen, look at who they chose, this Al Gore minion who's always presides over divvying up any crisis, divvying up the billions to insiders. No medical training, no intelligence training, no military training. And then Obama golfs all day and doesn't even have Ebola meetings. What's it look like to you?
Well, Ron Klein is a Washington fix-it man. He's, he was the guy that led the Gore operation in Florida when we had the contested election in 2002. I'm surprised. Where is the Surgeon General in this? I know there's not a confirmed Surgeon General. The Senate has dragged its feet on confirming Obama's pick. But there's got to be an acting Surgeon General. I mean, where is somebody like C. Everett Koop, who was in the front of of another disease that looks like it was traced back to CIA petri dishes of the 80s, and that was HIV/AIDS, decimated Africa's population. And the first people that actually brought it to the Western Hemisphere were Cuban troops fighting against CIA proxies in Angola that were infected when they got back to Cuba. And then, of course, we had the Mariel boat lift. And, well, we know the rest of that story, how it spread over here. But anyway, Klein is a typical Washington fix-it man, and he's a PR flack. So, you know, just a few days ago, we heard of a lady on a shuttle bus at the Pentagon was heading down to the Marine Corps Commandant's change of command ceremony at the Marine Barracks on A Street in downtown D.C., and she started projectile vomiting, and then she said she had just been in West Africa. Well, we see what happens when you bring a guy like Klein on board. They said, oh, that lady never even had a passport. So
and we've got aircraft coming in out of West Africa, people dying, vomiting. They land at NYC, JFK, yeah. And they say, no problem. They don't have it without a test. I think it's safe to say, Wayne, that clearly they're covering up how many cases are in Africa and here.
I think so, because this is why they bring a guy like Klein on board, because he's going to put pressure on the corporate media to keep it quiet. You know, anytime we see something like this happens, it's just like 9/11, by the way. Remember they told people, well, you didn't see what you saw. Sorry, you had your facts wrong. And, you know, I was just, as a matter of fact, last month I was in New York speaking at a 9/11 commemorative function, and there's some new photographs that were released of that. And they were telling even reporters on the scene, oh, you must have been mistaken. It's the same thing. It's how the government deals with catastrophes.
Eddie?
It's, Yes.
Absolutely. Eddie, thank you so much for the call from New York. We're going to come back and go to Daniel, listening on WBCR 1470 in Knoxville. Lona, Charlie, and Sean, and many others. Wayne Madsen is our guest. Wide open phones, 800-259-9231. Infowars.com is the tip of the spear.
The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos. Read the information there compiled. And for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel body armor just won't quit.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
Using unparalleled research in the development of a synergistic formulation based around the key concepts of superoxygenation, the next level in cleansing is here. With key ingredients backed by real clinical studies, the new Oxy Powder, available through InfoWars Life, was invented during Dr. Group's research on the toxification of our bodies. Many herbal colon cleansers are harsh on the body and contain cheap and potentially dangerous ingredients, oftentimes full of synthetic fillers, GMOs, additives, or worse. Gently start cleaning your body with easy capsules that start working while you sleep. Oxy Powder does not require time off work, and there's no need for bad-tasting concoctions. Instead, Oxy Powder slowly releases monoatomic oxygen into the intestinal tract and body. Experience the astonishing cleansing power of superoxide and ozonide technology. Go to InfoWarsLife.com or InfoWarsStore.com to get started with Oxy Powder, or call 1-888-253-3139.
They call us walking corpses.
Waging war on corruption. It's Alex Jones coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
I hear a voice. I know it.
You're living hell.
British hell. Wayne Madsen of WayneMadsenReport.com is our guest. He's with us to the bottom of the hour. We'll talk some about his book before he leaves us, The Star and the Sword. Well, they want to lock a bunch of people up and put us in their pretty pens once an epidemic turns into a pandemic in this country. And I always go back to this because for me it's what really hits home. That if you watch the news and read the newspaper for 25 years, like I've done 20 years on air, but if you're like 60, 70 years old, you've been doing it for 40, 50 years, how do you not know that some shadowy shadow government, COG, that Eisenhower warned about, isn't in control? And then the documents all come out in the church hearings in the 70s and confirm it all. They just know the public is ignorant of all these facts. So they play this game going, oh, he's a conspiracy theory, or he's crazy. Thousands of different tests, hundreds of them lethal. In some cases, one of those hundreds of lethal secret programs would kill thousands of people, sterilize hundreds of thousands, kill millions. HIV, clearly cooked up by the Navy and the Army. Clearly, they had declassified programs for autoimmune viruses to reduce population. You got Bill Gates running around and the Rockefellers talking about it constantly. These outbreaks keep happening in Africa. And the average liberal trendy goes, well, there are too many people. But then they'll tell you you're a racist if you don't support government-run health care. I mean, it's like crazy that the big secret religion is population reduction. And then people say, well, Africa's population still went up. Must not be doing too good killing everybody. Some African countries, 45% of the people have HIV. Tens upon tens of millions have died. And now Ebola's popping up that we know our governments were souping up. South African, European countries, Israeli, U.S. I mean, I played a BBC News clip earlier about it. It's on Infowars.com that they weaponized Ebola. They had Ebola that was airborne in 1989 on the East Coast that got out. Of course they're making this stuff. And then we go, hey, the groups that make this stuff, maybe they're behind it. Kind of like maybe the government's behind the anthrax attack. Turns out it was U.S. government anthrax. Then they had a whole bunch of patsies they tried to blame. I want to go to your phone calls. Wayne Madsen's our guest. But Wayne, finishing up on this subject, again, former NSA officer, whistleblower, talking to your sources, where do they think, and where do you think this Ebola thing is going? I mean, you pretty much came out and said that you think it's a false flag and where it originated. And what's their bottom line here? Because politically, it's hurting them not to respond. But more and more, they know he's a lame duck, so they don't care. They've got pardons. They can resuscitate him in the media later, like they've done the Clintons and the Bushes and others. What's the grand plan here?
Well, my fear is that, you know, we've had Hollywood doing a lot of predictive programming on this. The latest one is this Planet of the Apes movie, where most of the human population is wiped out by something called simian flu. We know that Ebola is transmitted also from non-human primates, monkeys, chimpanzees, and gorillas. So my fear is what they're doing is they want to set up the first regime in the United States where they're going to have mandatory quarantine regions. They're going to have mandatory checks. They're going to highway checks to get people used to what happens to them every day at the airport is going to happen on interstate highways and other major roads. And where will they set up the checkpoints? Wherever they darn well please. You can imagine that way stations and toll stops are just made to order for this type of thing. But that, I think that's where we're going. They want to condition the American people to be able to do internal travel prohibitions and at the very least travel checks.
And Bill Clinton wrote back in 1998, we cover it in my 2000 film, Police State 2000. I mean, we show the statements, the executive orders about in the future, they would have hardened internal checkpoints at the state level, searching everyone. And a culture where you've got to give blood to get a driver's license and all this stuff, that's only begun the last 2 years in places like D.C. on a trial basis. Whatever they plan, they end up getting it, even if it's late. And you can see them, Wayne, as you just said, rolling this out. It follows where the border is open, but they have internal checkpoints at the airports. And illegals can fly, but citizens can't without being searched. And illegals can have bank accounts with no ID, but citizens have to. They're setting the precedent under this globalist model where you have internal checkpoints, but no longer national borders. It's completely upside down, but that is what they're doing.
And you know, and that's my fear, and that's why I think we have NORTHCOM involved with this. These Ebola SWAT teams. You know, late Friday, Obama did something very interesting. I'd say it's late. I'm glad he did it. He issued an executive order at like 5 o'clock on Friday afternoon, when most of the media is not paying attention, basically saying there will be no more research, government-sponsored research on these coronaviruses. That doesn't include Ebola, but it includes things like SARS, MERS, and influenza, avian flu, swine flu, the 1918 Spanish flu, which government scientists brought back to life after getting DNA from a dead Inuit girl, died of it in 1918.
That killed like 100 million people worldwide.